Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the A-Side. I am your host, Riley, and today I have a very special reaction for you. It's a recommendation and a request from my very good friend, Mikey. I've known him for a couple years now, and he's been supporting this channel since the absolute beginning. He's been asking me for a while to react to a certain album, and as a little Christmas gift, whether it be an early or late Christmas gift by the time this record video comes out, I will be reacting to one of his favorite albums of all time, Iridescence by Brockhampton. Now, if you are new around here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It's free, and you can always unsubscribe if you want. And if you want to see me react to the Brockhampton albums I haven't heard, that being Saturation 2 and 3, go ahead and leave a like, and I will talk about those records. I've talked about Brockhampton a couple times on this channel. I have listened to, reviewed Iridescence and the newest record, Roadrunner, New Light, New Machine. And I have heard Ginger plenty of times when that came out in 2019, pre the A-side existing. So, yeah, I am definitely pretty familiar with their discography for the most part. And I will be listening to Iridescence here for the first time. I did get to hear a little bit of New Orleans, because some technical difficulties were happening, and they still kind of are, so hopefully this doesn't sound awful. Anyway, let's just get right into it. Let's just start with New Orleans.
Perfectly fine.
All right.
That's fine. Said nigga, brother, what you living for? They should go finish what you started, what you quitting for?
Immediately, I love the beat. Like, I just love the how it's, like, buzzy, and I think the 808s hit really hard here.
I'm independent because these parties never play for this. Brother nigga with a brain, unintentionally swerving in every lane. The feeling's never the same, you chase what you couldn't gain. I'm so accustomed to flames, I couldn't tell you.
It's just a really cool sound, and I think his flow is really cool too. How he's doing the, like, weird inflections. I appreciate that. One problem I do have with Brockhampton every once in a while is I feel like their song's going a little long because there are so many members of the group that want to get their verse in. Sometimes I feel like, oh, maybe it's a little too long. Although looking at the track listing, it doesn't seem like it's going to be like that. I like that part. Boom, 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 boom. Nice little epic moment for, like, a little build up. Like I said, when it comes to Brockhampton, I much prefer their poppier, more catchy, hooky songs, like I'll Take You On, to their more hardcore kind of hip hop songs. The same goes for, like, the Saturation, like, Gold Chain. I love the hook on that song. For me, it's the hooks that really get me, so. Definitely cool.
Depending that this the only sign of life, I'm throwing Hail Mary.
Oh, this verse is going hard. The way he's delivering this is so cool.
I don't need them shits, learn to fly again. Fast track to last place, I swear I've never been on top, but I'm up here somewhere. Out here, nobody can tell me shit. Never mind what I did back then. You should take a look at yourself instead. Maybe you can find yourself, love yourself. Here's the help, and here's
that one hard. Well, that was a hard verse. Big fan of that. Yeah. Very cool. Oh, the drums? They're not real drums, but the drum machines are hitting really hard here. This entire song, they're really just pounding it.
Put my life out of dirt. That's a miracle. If Jesus was a pop star, would he
spread the bad. This is my rating scale. You probably all know. Red if it's bad, green if it's good. The ever coveted black GameCube controller, if it is just meh or okay. I am going to give that song green. I thought the beat was cool, despite not really changing much over its 4-minute runtime, just kind of being a little repetitive. But I think where the song stays fresh is the many members of this band switching up the flows and stuff and switching up the MC. And I think some of those verses were really cool. Some of them have really interesting flows. I can't recognize them by their voice. I know some of them. I know there's like Joba and Kevin Abstract and Merlin, and there are more. There's a lot of people. But those are the ones I know. Sorry. But yeah, that gets the green. I thought it was cool. Anyway, next track, Thug Life. Thug Life chose me. I didn't choose it. Ooh. Immediately, this is stuff I really like from Brockhampton. I love these pretty pianos and then the like chorus. This is really pretty. Oh, I have to say, that's the same drum line. Bum, 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 from New Orleans. The vocals here are amazing, though. They sound great, and the piano sounds so rich. See, this is what's great from Brockhampton. It's like the weird pop rap, like experimental pop rap. I love this kind of stuff from the band. It's different, like a silo of skeletons I know I possess. I saw perfection out in ways I know. But like, I don't want to say clunky, because clunky is bad, but the detached kind of flow here with the vocal effects is really cool. Inside. They 10 feet tall with no eyes. They put my head in the water, and it's so beautiful under the sun reflecting off the corals. Colors I can't describe to make the darkness divine. Oh, the piano sound really good here. Harmony, 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 harmony. Big fan. Big harmony enjoyer here on the A side. I like that. This album cover is so bad, though. I'm not even gonna lie. The album cover for this record is awful. yeah! Thug Life was really pretty. I'm gonna give that the green. It wasn't too long. It was just a nice little short song. With really pretty vocals and, like, weird delivery and beautiful, like, lush pianos. Just good stuff. Really like that. Next track, Berlin. This one's not really connecting to me that much so far. At first, I thought the distorted drums were cool, but now they're kind of getting on my nerves. For decoration, so baby boy, it's the occasion. You just said you're about to take over a nation. Avoid the social litigation when the admiration turns into operation. Y'all can find another station. Is your backbone? Yeah, I'm not messing with this song. I think that synth is kind of grating, actually. The kind of like whistling synth, whimpering. It sounds like it's whimpering. I don't know, this track's just getting on my nerves, man. The muddy drums aren't doing it for me here. Honestly, I'm going to give Berlin the red. I didn't like that song. It just felt annoying in its worst parts, and in its best parts, it just didn't connect with me. I didn't like that the kind of whimpering synth in the background that sounded like it was letting out its last breaths. And these muddy, loud drums are just kind of getting on my nerves. I don't know. Let's continue. Okay, track 4, Something About Him. Flashing, there's something about him. Yeah, his attitude is like magic. There's something about him. I know I got to have it. You know, maybe it's just me, but the production on this record isn't working for me. The way it sounds is just not working for me. I can't put it into words, but it just kind of sounds gross. This track isn't as bad. I like the kind of sweetness of this song. I like the piano and like the vocal melodies, but the production on the vocals and the production as a song in a whole, I don't think is doing great. But I'm liking parts of this. Cool elements, but I think was ultimately bogged down by its production. I'm gonna give Something About Him the black GameCube controller. I liked the synths, I liked the tone and what it was going for, like lyrically and melodically, but just the sound of it, the way it just sounds and is put to tape. Is just not appealing to me in this situation. Or really. Pull to your house and dump like a trash man. Pull up in your grill, but I'm not a fan. Banger? Banger alert? There's someone to catch that. There's someone to have said. But there's someone to catch. Well, this video is being marred by technical difficulties, among other things. So I'm sorry if that last segment of where the cash app was a little choppy. Very quickly, I just think it was a lot of fun. It's just a banger of a song. Anyway, I'm just going to react to one last song, wait, and then call it a day and do part 2 another time. So yeah, let's just get to it. Wait. I ain't heard from my nieces. I've been feeling defeated, like I'm the worst in the boy band. I ain't sleeping some weekends, trying to hit my weekends. Leave my niggas out sheeping. I keep the world in my hands. I know accounts should be deleted. I know some niggas should stop hitting my phone whenever they need it. Money, your favor's done. Cause I'm still worried about when Ashland finna put the razor down. So I don't really give a fuck about what story they done spun. And I ain't done. That string section at the beginning was very beautiful. He gave me cold signs. I was writing poems by the dog and study hall. Yeah, I like a lot of the musical stuff going on in the beat here. The strings and the saxophone and stuff. I thought I had a problem. Kept my head inside a pillow screaming. I don't wanna waste no more time. I'm ready to go. Oh my. That's a cool like drum beat here. It almost sounds real. Life is a dish served cold most times. I like that lyric a lot. Smile.
My mother called me today. She said she thought she felt my energy a country away. I apologize for not calling enough due to weight, but couldn't tell you if I kept it in my head to decay. I asked her why this world of echoing hate. She said don't let those songs know you start dictating your fate. I think the hardest part of love could be rebuilding the breaks. Conditioned to admit the mental our foundation will shake. There's no debate, the road to peace is filled with snakes. You gotta keep you cool and recognize the wolves that wanna try and leave you wool. Don't let them treat you like a window, you know you a jewel. This world is cruel and not as simple as they teach in schools. Sometimes you gotta
the way this beat is continually switched up and stays fresh, cause this song is almost 4.5 minutes. So the way it keeps switching up what it's doing, it just keeps the song interesting and keeps me from getting bored. Whereas sometimes, you know, some of these songs earlier, like New Orleans, over 4 minutes, same beat the entire time. I like how this is switching up what it's doing.
Start the game again.
Pressure makes me lash back. Wish I could get past that. I can't take a step back. Makes me wish you passed that.
Chill beat with a little more intense vocal delivery, which is interesting juxtaposition. I like that. Can hear Andre 3000 inspiration on the vocals, the falsetto. I really like it though. Cool. I think that was my favorite song so far, either that or Thug Life. I like both of those songs a lot. I like the strings throughout the entirety of the track and the instrumentation on it, but I also like that it kept switching up the beat and the tempo and kept things interesting and fresh the entire time. So that gets the green for me. Yeah, this record's fine so far. I don't like it as much as Roadrunner. Definitely not as much as Roadrunner. I don't like it as much as Saturation 1 or Ginger. But it's fine so far, yeah. I'm gonna end it here. I'm sorry if this video was a little rough. Technical difficulties started popping up around halfway through recording. And sadly, you can't re-record a first reaction, so I'm just gonna have to make it work. But I hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned for part two. Perhaps that'll be after your endless season. So yeah, thank you genuinely for watching. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, whatever you celebrate. And I'll see you all next time.